Y'all, I have been sitting here running my mouth for about 7 minutes and realized that I wasn't recording anything. What's up, y'all? This is Rodney and I'm back. I'm not gonna let that ruin my day. I'm not gonna let that ruin my day. So we're gonna smile and we're gonna push through. Even though I feel like getting in the bed because I'm really low-key over it, but that's okay. What's up, y'all? This is Rodney and I'm back and I feel like running my mouth just for a little bit, even though I did for about 7 minutes ago and it wasn't recording. Yesterday, you know, I wanted to try something new. You know, I wanted to give y'all more of a podcast feel, right? Because let me stop lying to y'all faces. I was being lazy. All I wanted to do was lay in bed with my drawers on, drink, and watch TV. But I also felt like running my mouth and being a little messy, right? So I was like, how can I run my mouth and be messy but not have to get out of my bed and brush my teeth and wash my face? So girl, I politely laid that phone on that mattress and I got to running my mouth, right? You know, I don't know if y'all know, I have Invisalign now. So I have Invisalign. And just like when I had my braces, like my retainer for my braces, you know, you have to take your Invisalign out, brush it, all that stuff. And it just takes a few extra minutes, but I didn't feel like doing all that yesterday until that night. Once it hit night, you know, I kind of got in the streets a little bit. So I had to get up and, you know, get myself together, right? But anyways, we'll be back. I wanted to talk about Miss Carly Red and Lamar Odom and some other and some more people. So Carly Red decided to get online and she said it would have never worked because he needs rehab, not a relationship or a situationship. Now for me, the first person that popped in my mind was Lamar Odom. And the reason being was because, or is because, we know that Lamar Odom is gonna appear on this season of Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. I don't know in what capacity, I don't know what him and Carly Red had going on. I don't know if they were boyfriend and girlfriend, if they just had a one night stand, if they had just went on a couple of dates and then they realized that they were not compatible. I don't know. We'll find out. But the first person that popped in my mind was Carly Red. So I guess Carly Red caught wind that she made the blogs. And then she came back and said, I repost quotes all the time, but you take this one to repost, shaking my head. Everything is not always about me. And then somebody hit her back and said, where's the quote? Hello? Then Lamar caught wind of what Carly Red said, and he came back and he said this: anything to stay relevant. I generally do not address this type of nonsense, but come on, at Carly Red, what is this about? Listen, me being in recovery is no secret. I've made some amazing strides and I no longer do drugs. Hashtag facts. But I do need rehab. I need to be rehabilitated from my attraction to toxic, bitter and unhealthy relationships with women who need therapy more than they need me. Now I'm not going to go low like you're doing, take jabs, tell lies, because at the end of the day, I was married to a Kardashian. So anything less than that is like going from sugar to shit. Hashtag it's like that. Hashtag the first black Kardashian. Hashtag low. Hashtag Lammy back. Hashtag Lakers. Hashtag veteran. Hashtag growing. Hashtag building. Hashtag journey. Hashtag facts. Hashtag grateful. He also came back and said, I'm no longer responding to false allegations made about me. You will be hearing from my lawyer. Now, let me say this. I got some stuff I want to say. Okay, Carly, I think you're full of... Because at the end of the day, you had to have known that you putting that out would get people talking. And then again, Carly, you are a reality TV star. And right now it's Love and Hip Hop season. So anything that you need to do to drum up some attention for your storyline, I think that's exactly what you're going to do, right? So I don't think that it just was, you know, you just quoting some quote. I think you knew exactly what you were doing, like the majority of these reality TV stars know what they're doing. Now, with that being said, Lamar. I think people get so caught. Maybe so. You know what it is? Sometimes I think I pay attention to the stuff that don't nobody else pay attention to. Because sometimes y'all say I'm off. That's fine. I think sometimes y'all off too, right? So the feeling is mutual. But the part that stuck out to me. Well, I look cute. Girl, I look cute. I'm cute. Bitch, I'm cute. I am. Girl, let's see. I just looked at the camera like, girl, you cute. Well, I didn't just realize I was cute, but I'm cute. So anyways, so listen. The point that got me was, I'm not going to go low like you're doing, take jabs, tell lies, because at the end of the day, I was married to a Kardashian, so anything less than that is like going from sugar to... Girl, when I tell you Lamar is the definition of once you go white, you gonna always think it's right. Lamar, did you really just get on here and call? Like, this is a thing, right? And men and women both do this. You'll date somebody, whether it was long-term, short-term, just to hit it and quit it. Then all of a sudden, women get mad, and then the men, that's all right, because you got a smile at. Anyway, well, girl, it wasn't too small because you were doing a whole bunch of hopping on the girl, right? You know? Then if the man get mad, then it's on your... Well, did it really stay? Because your face was in her place for a long time. Because she told me you ate her apple about 45 minutes straight. So did it really stay? Right? So we know that when men and women get mad, or just people, period, in a relationship, whether it's a gay relationship or a straight relationship or whatever that it was, right? We know that you start taking jabs. But girl, you really on here hopping up the Kardashians like that? Like, Lamar, I need you to understand the Kardashians will never have you in their circle again. Again. Ever again. I don't know what Lamar's obsession is with the Kardashians, but it's weird. The simple fact that this grown black man is on here talking about hashtag the first black Kardashian. Like, it would be different if Lamar was like some just bum off the streets. You see what I'm saying? Trying to leech onto that name or latch onto that name. But Lamar Odom, if you are all these things that you say you are, a Laker, a veteran, you know, all that, then you really don't need to be on here bragging about the first black Kardashian. I don't know. I felt some type of way. But I really, like, Carly gets on my nerves. Carly, you know, is messy. But I really felt some type of way about him getting on her calling. I don't know. Maybe I'm sensitive. Maybe I am. I don't like the fact that he called her. I don't know. Because I say a lot of stuff about people. He called that girl shit. And called the Kardashian sugar. Let me tell you something, baby. Y'all can take this how y'all want to take it. Ain't no crackhead gonna ever try to get me together online, period. I know that sound mean. I wish a motherfucking crackhead would tell me that I'm shit. Girl, what? No, the shit that you were smoking was shit. That's why your ass almost went home to glory, right? Girl, he just called that black woman shit. Girl, that's y'all homeboy. That's y'all homeboy. I was, baby, please, I would have wore Lamar out online. Baby, this is the type of shit where I would have to come back and apologize. Because even though I wouldn't mean it, but people would probably force me into apologizing. Because I would have called Lamar all types of crackheads and dope fiends and, girl, all types of disrespectful shit. Lamar, you got some nerve. You really got some nerve. You got some nerve. You really got some nerve getting your black ass online. Girl, when I tell you, baby, I don't know what the Kardashians be putting on these men. They say it's a Kardashian curse. Is it a Kardashian curse? I don't know, girl. Speaking of the Kardashians, girl, let's go ahead and talk about Tristan Thompson says that Khloe Kardashian, she will never leave. Now, according to the Neighborhood Talk, you know we love the Neighborhood Talk. They said, according to The Mirror, Tristan Thompson is confident he'll win ex Khloe Kardashian after his latest cheating scandal. They say that Khloe will never leave him as they've got They've got too much history. The last time she dumped him, he sent flowers and spent loads of money on jewelry, spa days, and getaways for her and True. She's a sucker for treats. Basically, Tristan just said, you a dumb bitch, you ain't going nowhere. Girl, y'all can't be talking. These y'all men, if y'all think everybody wants them, girl. He just called you a dumb bitch, girl, basically. He said you ain't going nowhere. And the sad thing about it, this is alleged. This is coming from an alleged source. But I believe it. Like, the crazy thing is, even though Chloe can, everything that Tristan can buy Chloe, she can buy for herself times 10. But it's so weird how, like, a man, like, somebody can cheat. And if they buy you spa days and jewelry, girl, that's enough to show, well, he's trying. Is he really trying? Because this is how I look at situations. When we find out that somebody has cheated in a relationship, girl, they probably cheated 10 more times than that. Like, we found out that Offset cheated on Cardi, what, 3 or 4 times? It's probably been about 7 or 8. Girl, we know that Tristan has cheated on Chloe about 3 or 4 times. It's probably been about 9 or 10, right? Girl, y'all crazy. Chloe, you crazy. Girl, he know you dumb. He know you ain't going nowhere. We all know you ain't going nowhere, right? Now, let's go ahead and talk about Keely Williams. Can I say something, y'all? So, everybody been talking about Cliff Huxtable. Because I think that's what everybody... That's who I think... I've come to realize that I think a lot of people think that Cliff Huxtable was the one who went to jail. And I don't think that people can separate the character from the man, which is Bill Cosby, right? Like, I don't think that people can separate Claire Huxtable from Felicia Rashad. And I grew up in a single parent home, right? I didn't grow up with both parents in my home, but sometimes it crosses my mind that a lot of you really grew up, like, looking at Cliff Huxtable as your father, or Claire Huxtable as your father, right? I mean, as your mother. Like, it's so weird to me when I see people who can't separate the two, right? So I said Keely Williams, Notori. That's not a Notori from Power. She said, why are Black people so quick to cancel each other? I will say this much. I don't think I like the cancel culture either, because one thing I've noticed is that you can do the smallest of the smallest of the smallest things and just get online and see how many people will be, like, being a cheerleader for, let's cancel them. Girl, like, you can't do nothing wrong, right? Nothing. Like, everything people want to cancel. We are allowed to have different opinions, and it doesn't make you anti anything. At Felicia Rashad, I stand with you. Hashtag The Cosby Show changed lives. Yes, it changed lives, but baby, it was a show. And just because the Cosby Show changed lives does not mean that if someone goes out here and they violate people, they should not be held responsible. This is the thing that it's hard for me to wrap my brain around too, is how I've seen so many people say that the Cosby Show should not be taken out of syndication, right? They should keep playing it because these people depend on these checks to, you know, for their livelihood. Y'all worried about that, but then just listen to me. When it came to Trick Daddy only saying that Beyonce couldn't sing, y'all did not have a problem with potentially affecting this man's livelihood. And the people that work at that restaurant, which more than likely, they probably live check to check, right? That's, I don't understand sometimes the way that people think. Everybody was cheering and going up in the air that people were going online giving Trick Daddy restaurant fake reviews and they hadn't even been there, right? Everybody was going up because he said Beyonce can't sing. And my response was, it would be different if Trick Daddy was out here causing chaos and confusion in these streets, violating folk, messing with kids. I could wrap my brain around that. But girl, you're not gonna get me to understand that this is okay and all this man said this woman couldn't sing. But all of a sudden, girl, we need to show grace and have mercy and have understanding for the people that were affected because of what Bill Cosby did. Or allegedly did. Now we need to understand the people that need their checks. I'm sorry, the Cosby Show was fake. It wasn't real. That doesn't mean that we don't have real life Cosbys in the world. We know we do. But girl, the Cosby Show was fake. It was fake. It was not real. Cliff Huxtable was a fictional character. Felicia Rashad was a fictional character. Period. So Keely comes out. We know Keely. Again, Notorious from 3LW. Keely is from 3LW. So Keely comes out and she says, Somebody bring me a two-piece. She talking crazy again. And you know the story back in the day when 3LW broke up was that Keely had allegedly thrown some chicken at Notori, but she's never admitted to it. Do I think Keely threw that chicken at Notori? Yes. Do I think that this is her way of thinking that she's smarter than everybody by, you know how some people do that, play that whole game of, I'ma say this, but I'm gonna try to act like I'm not admitting it, but girl, you threw the chicken at her. However, Keely, you got a whole bunch of mouth on the internet, because when they ask us for getting you together at the house on BET Presents the Encore, either one, you standing there letting Aubrey White ask you together, or two, you running off in the kitchen crying. Girl, but now you got all this goddamn lip. Now you got all this lip. But girl, the other day, on the Encore, girl, they had your ass crying, running to the kitchen, thinking about leaving the house. But now, girl, Keely, you an internet thug. You one of them girls I be talking about that want to have all that lip online, girl, with a flower as your picture, or with a bumblebee as your picture. But you got so much to say. But when that white bitch was getting your ass together, calling you a bitch all up and through your face, girl, you sat there and you ain't say shit. Fucking bitch. Aubrey disrespected you to your face in front of everybody and you ain't said shit. Man, Aubrey would have tore that kitchen up, girl. We would have been tongue thrashing that kitchen down. Girl, I would have told Aubrey up, girl. And I'm not talking about physical, I'm talking about I would have cussed her eye. But you didn't. But now you want to get online with a whole bunch to say. Anyways, I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.